Hello, today we will discuss the capacitor, how to calculate the capacitance of the different types of the capacitor. For example, parallel plate capacitor, co-axial capacitor and the spherical capacitor. So first of all, we will see what is the capacitor. So first of all, heading capacitor. What is the capacitor? So capacitor. So if there are two conducting plate of any size, so we are taking arbitrary size, and second is the this side. Upon the first charge is plus Q. Upon the first plate, charge is plus Q, and upon the second plate, charge is minus Q, and we apply the potential. So this is the capacitor. This form the capacitor. So to form the capacitor, there must be two conducting plate, and charge upon the plate will be same in magnitude and opposite in direction. If the charge upon the plate is same in magnitude and opposite in direction, then all the flux originated from the positive charge and terminated at the negative charge. So all the flux originated from the positive charge and terminated at the negative charge. So this is the, there are two initial, there are two conditions to form the capacitor. One is must to have the capacitor. First is to have a capacitor we must have two or more conductors carrying equal but opposite charges. So if the carrying equal but opposite charge, if the charge will be equal and there is opposite, so all the flux originated from the positive charge and terminated at the negative charge. So to calculate the capacitance, we know the formula of the capacitance, C equal to mod of Q upon V, where Q is the charge upon the capacitor and V is the potential difference between the conductor. V is the potential difference between the conductor or between the plates. We calculate the potential difference, V equal to minus E vector dot dl vector. So this is the formula to calculate the potential difference between the conductor. So if we calculate the electric field between the conductors, then by using this formula, we can calculate the potential difference. And if we calculate the potential difference, then we calculate the capacitance of the capacitor. So method to calculate the capacitance. Write down. Method to calculate the capacitance. Method to calculate the capacitance. First method is choose a suitable coordinate system. First of all, we have to choose a suitable coordinate system. For example, for different types of the capacitor, there are different types of the coordinate system. So there are so many types of the capacitor: parallel plate capacitor, coaxial capacitor, and the spherical capacitor. For different types of the capacitor, we have to choose different types of the coordinate system, for a rectangular coordinate system, a spherical coordinate system, or the cylindrical coordinate system. Second is, let the two conducting charge carrying charges plus or minus equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. Let the to conducting plates carry charges plus Q and minus Q. Then third is, we determine the electric field by using the either Coulomb's law or the Gauss law. We calculate the electric field by using either Coulomb's law or Gauss law. Then we calculate the potential difference by using this formula, and then we calculate the capacitance by Q upon V. So first of all, we calculate the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. Write down the heading. Parallel plate capacitor. Parallel plate capacitor. Now, first of all, we draw the diagram of the parallel plate capacitor. So there are two conducting plate one, and this is the plate two. Upon the plate one, there is the plus Q charge. So this is the plus Q charge. On the plate two, there is the minus Q charge. So this is the minus Q charge. Upon this, this is the plus Q charge, and this is the minus Q charge. We have to calculate the capacitance of the this parallel plate capacitor. We know the charge upon the capacitance. What is the formula of the capacitance? C equal to mod of Q upon V. So we know the charge upon the capacitor. Just we have to calculate the potential difference between the plates 1 and 2. And we know the formula of the potential difference is minus E vector dot EL vector. So to calculate the capacitance, we must know the potential difference between the plates. The separation between the plate is A. Medium, permittivity of the medium inside the parallel plate capacitor is epsilon. Area of the plate is A. Area of the both plate is same. So if we calculate the electric field intensity inside the plate in any way, then we can calculate the potential difference between the plates. We know the electric field intensity due to the infinite surface charge. Electric field intensity due to infinite charge cities rho s upon 2 epsilon. Rho s is the charge density upon the plate, and epsilon is the permittivity of the medium. And we can also write rho s is the charge density, so the charge upon the area, total charge upon the area. So at this point, the electric field intensity due to the plus charge is this way, rho s upon 2 epsilon naught, because these are the positive, so it will repel. Now electric field intensity due to the minus Q charge, so this is the minus, so it will attract, and again the formula will be same, rho s upon 2 epsilon, so net electric field intensity or resultant electric field intensity inside the capacitor, resultant electric field intensity is equal to rho s upon epsilon. Now we calculate the potential difference. We will see the next derivation in the next video.